Good afternoon, students. I hope you are all well. Okay. Now we are on chapter 10. Chapter 10 is of quadrilaterals. Okay. And in this chapter 10, we have learned about what are quadrilaterals. We have learned about its definitions. Okay. Let me revise some for you. For quadrilaterals, we have learned that it has four edges, four vertices, two diagonals. Sum of all the interior angles is 360 degree, and sum of all the exterior angle is also 360 degree. Apart from that, for quadrilaterals and as well as for every polygon, we know that sum of all the exterior angle of polygon is 360 degree, that we have already noted, and also the sum of all the interior angles of a polygon. This is the important formula that I have shown to you. Sum of all the interior angles of a polygon is n minus 2 into 180 degree, as well as value of each interior angle of a regular polygon is n minus 2 into 180 degree upon n. Okay. So on the basis of all these three information, we were doing the exercise, and we had question number 9 on our hand. I did question number 9 C and D part. Now I am going to do question number 9 A and B part, which I left for you, but some of the students have asked about it. So question number 9 A part, first of all, let me draw the diagram for you. Diagram is like this. We have a BC line, a BA line at a slant, AD line, and this name is A, B, C and D. This angle is 105 degree, this angle is 70 degree, angle C is 110 degree, and angle X, D is angle X. We have to determine the value of X. Now students have been asking me what to do in this question. I've told you again and again to repeat the theory, to go through the theory once again and again and again, so that you can keep that in your mind. It is very important to learn the theory in order to do all these questions. If you do not know your theory, you will not be able to do these questions. The thing is, I've told you for any quadrilateral, sum of all the interior angle is always 360 degree. For any quadrilateral, sum of all the interior angle is always 360 degree. That means for this quadrilateral ABCD, listen carefully. For this quadrilateral ABCD, angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D are all equal to 360 degree. If you add all of these angles, the answer is always going to be equal to 360 degree. Now, out of all of these angles, you already know the value of angle A. You know the value of angle B. You know the value of angle C. And you do not know the value of angle D. Now, you have to find the value of X. And I hope all of you can complete the question now. Okay, the same sort of thing is to be done with the B part. I will explain it shortly to you. B part is, there is a line at the base. This is the figure given to you in the B part. P, L, M, N. First of all, this type of diagram is made. This sign means that this angle and this angle are both 90 degree. Okay, that is the meaning of this sign. This is the indication that angle L on the both side of the line PL is 90 degree. Secondly, angle N is 40 degree and angle M is 80 degree. You have to find the value of angle P, that is X. Once again, what you will say that in the quadrilateral P, N, M, L, in this quadrilateral, sum of all the angles, that is angle P plus angle N plus angle M plus angle L is all equal to 180 degree. I am writing again and again 180 degree. That is incorrect. It is all equal to 360 degree. Okay? And once you do that, you put in the values of P, N, M and L angles, and after that you can get the value of X. By solving that, you can get the value of X. We did this in other two questions as well. Okay, I hope it is all understandable to you. Once again, without understanding the theory, you will not be able to do the questions. And if you are, even after understanding the theory, if you are unable to do the question, then do solve the examples of this chapter. Examples are very important. They can give you a better insight to how to do the questions. Now, question number 10, as we planned. Now, question number 10 and 11 are remaining out of exercise 10.1. So, let me write down question number 10 for you, and after that we can solve it. Question number 10 is, in the given figure, you do not need to write down the question right now, okay? But when you are doing this question in your homework copy, you do need to write it down. P is a point in the interior of angle RSQ PR is perpendicular to PS and PQ is perpendicular to QS if angle RSQ is 29 degree find the measure of angle RPQ. Once again, you do not need to write down this question right now, okay? You do understand the meaning of this question, and I will tell you beforehand, you have to do this question in your homework copy as well. Diagram is like this. This is point P here. There is point R. And this is point Q. This is point S. So according to the question, these two are right angles. That means this angle is 90 degree as well as angle R is 90 degree. You are given the value of angle RSQ. RSQ, that is this angle. This angle right here is 29. You need to determine the value of angle RPQ. Okay. So once again, like we did in the previous questions, let me change the pen for solution. In quadrilateral PQRS, in this quadrilateral, sum of all these angles is equals to 180 degree. That is angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S is equals to 360 degree. I spoke 180 earlier, that was wrong, 360 degree. Sum of all these four angles is equals to 360 degree, okay. Now we don't know the value of angle P, then angle P remains as it is. Angle Q is 90 degree, angle R is again 90 degree, and angle S is 29 degree. PQSR is equals to 360 degree. That is what diagram was utilized for. Now there is no need for diagram. And once again, students, when you are doing your solution in your homework copy in any of the geometry question, if there is a diagram present in the question, you have to definitely draw that diagram in your homework copy. you have to do question number 10 and 11 in your homework copy as well, question number 9 as well, and the previous homework was given in the previous video. Now angle P, 90 plus 90 is 180, 180 plus 129 is 209 degree, is equals to 360 degree. So this will be, angle P will be equal to 360 degree minus 209 degree. 160 minus 9 is 151 degree. So final value of angle P will be equal to 151 degree. Okay. This will be your final answer. Now, in the same manner, you have question number 11, but question number 11 is a bit more complicated than question number 10. So let me first write down question number 11, and then I will tell you the solution. In question number 11, PQRS is a quadrilateral. ST and RT are bisectors of angle PSR and angle SRQ respectively. If angle SPQ is equal to 120 degree, you have to determine the value of angle. We have to find angle PQR. Let us see in the diagram how is it. See, you have a quadrilateral PQSR. P is smaller length, and then this, and then this, and this is SR. The name is PQSR. Okay, this angle P is equals to 120 degree. In this quadrilateral, ST and SR are bisectors of angle S and angle R. What is happening here is a line ST, let me make a proper line for you. A line ST is angle bisector of angle S, and a line RT is angle bisector of angle R. Okay. This here is point T, such that this angle is 30 degree. And this angle SRT is 35 degree. Okay, students, I hope you already know what an angle bisector is. If you don't, please write down this definition. Okay, what is an angle bisector? It is a line which divides an angle in two equal parts . Okay, so let me explain with the help of diagram. Suppose this is an angle PQR and QT is an angle bisector. So what happens here is, if QT is angle bisector of angle PQR, in that case what will happen is angle PQT will be equal to angle TQR will be equal to half of angle Q. That means if this part is X, this part will also be X and this angle will be 2X. Okay? Or conversely, you can say that if you can say this whole angle is X, then this angle will be X by 2 and this part will also be equal to X by 2. That is the meaning of angle bisector. It divides an angle into two equal parts. It divides an angle into two parts of equal degree. Okay. Suppose you draw an angle bisector to a 50 degree angle, you get two angles of 25 degree 25 degree. Suppose you draw an angle bisector of 90 degree, you get two angles of 45 degree and 45 degree. Suppose you draw an angle bisector to 120 degree, you get two smaller angles of 60 degree and 60 degree. That is how angle bisector works. Okay, so where were we? Yeah, so using this information, I can see here that ST is the angle bisector. That must mean this part should also be equal to 30 degree and this part should also be equal to 35 degree. Okay, so how will I write it? In solution, first of all, I will say, since for angle S, ST is angle bisector, ST is angle bisector, so that means angle S is equals to twice of angle TSR. That means value of angle S should be equal to 2 into 30 degree, that is 60 degree. Okay? And similar sort of thing I will say for angle R also. RT is bisector of angle R. That will mean that angle R should be equal to twice of angle TRS. This will be 2 into 35 degree, that is equals to 70 degree. Now in this quadrilateral, what is the quadrilateral? This is the quadrilateral PQRS. In this quadrilateral, we know the value of angle R, we know the value of angle S, and we know the value of angle Q. Can we not determine the value of angle Q? Okay. In quadrilateral PQRS, angle P plus angle Q plus angle R plus angle S should all be equal to 360 degree. Sum of all these angles should be equal to 360 degree. So let us see. We have angle P as 120 degree. Angle Q, we don't know the value of angle Q, we have to determine it. Angle R is 70 degree and angle S is 60 degree. So we will simplify it. This will be angle Q plus 60 plus 120, 180, 180 plus 70, 0, 2, 5. That means angle Q will be equal to 360 degree minus 250 degree. Is equals to 110 degree. Okay? So in this manner we have determined, or you can say, you can also tell angle Q as angle PQR. You can write down its full name as 110 degree. Okay, that is up to you. Up till here it is all okay. So if you encounter any problem in this exercise, kindly inform me. Okay, so once again, for today's homework, you have to do question number, remaining parts of question number 9 and question number 10 and question number 11 in your homework of yesterday.